Hey guys, my name's Hunter, and today I'm going to be bringing you on a day in the life of what it's like to be a LaunchX student. I don't have too much time right now. I've got a class in about 5 minutes. It starts at 8 a.m., and we're going to be learning about building social media engagement, and it's being taught by David Henderson. So super excited for that class. I love David Henderson. I love his classes, and I'm ready to learn about social media engagement, so see you guys there.
We're enjoying the class right now, and I will see you guys there.
Hey guys, class just finished. I can say without a doubt that was probably one of my favorite classes I've taken here at LaunchX. So there's about an hour till the next class, and I'm gonna get on a meeting with my team to work on our presentation for the mock board. Also, I just got a notification, which I'm gonna post right here. My team and I just got our budget approved for our startup, so we're gonna go ahead and order everything we need to on Amazon so we can get that shipped here and ready to sell some products.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah? Well, I had a class just literally an hour ago, so I've been up for a little bit. Yeah, no, it was a cool class. Yeah, he showed us some people who, like, have really interesting social media feeds. They had, like, cinematic experiences, as he called them. And definitely some cool things. Yeah, you definitely should. It was a cool class. And obviously, it's taught by David Henderson, so kind of just by default, it was a good class. Okay. I'm okay with that. Yeah, okay, so, like, we've had a follow-up saying we've, like, we'll send you an email, like, a couple days with the payment thing, and then, like, yeah, I guess that's, like, gonna be how we do it. Hey, guys, I'm near the end of my team meeting, and it is an exciting time. We are about to place our order for our prototyping materials after we got our budget approved. I'm jumping between my meeting and selling skills class right now, and I just want to say really quick, something about actually ordering everything for my prototype brings this to life. It feels really real that now that these things are actually coming to my house, and I'm going to be building this product within the next couple days. So I just wanted to share that, but I'm going to jump into my selling skills class right now. I can go after this. It's not so much my person's fault, but so they were talking about how you should buy mugs so you have coffee so you can wake up for LaunchX, right? And that's appealing to me, but since you mentioned coffee, I'm thinking I don't drink coffee, like I don't like the taste of coffee. So I guess that kind of like excluded me from that. But I would think the majority of people buying a mug would be coffee people, so maybe that's just like a more of a me thing. He didn't do bad selling, I thought it was a good pitch. Again, awesome class. I love hearing from Bert, like listening to his classes, and I was able to engage a lot. What I love about Bert is if you engage in his classes, he'll use you in his examples because he show up on his little Zoom screen. So I love being used in examples and him like referencing me in the class, and overall it makes it feel like really interactive. So yeah, it was a great class, and I'm looking forward to one more class for the day. Let me check. I believe I have to go to my next class is iterations, which starts in 2 minutes. So I will see you guys there. Once again, a great class. We had this fun breakout room activity where we had a pitch a company in 30 seconds and other members would set goals for a company or what they think would be difficult to do but achievable. So I'd say really fun class, and I look forward to taking more like it. But on a related note, we have a new entrepreneur with us. This is the first dog entrepreneur ever at LaunchX. And he's gonna be helping us for the rest of the day. So thank you, buddy. Me and the dog entrepreneur are soon headed to our next team meeting, where we're going to finalize our slides for our mock board pitch and hopefully work on our marketing strategy, because we're trying to get a Facebook post out for my local HOA so they can advertise for a company. So we'll get right to that. And you ready, buddy? Ready? He's excited. Hey guys, we're back. We're near the end of the team meeting, and I just want to give you guys a quick update. I want you all to behold this beautiful image that my teammate Akil has created. This is a 3D rendering of what our product will look like. And I cannot tell you how hyped I am to look at this thing. This thing is beautiful. This is going on our slides. We're going to showcase it however we can. And we're also going to put a bunch of other stuff on our slides. I got a couple responses on emails about how we can reach out to, let me grab the names here. We're reaching out to a general manager at a Harris Teeter, the Department of Economic Development in my county, and the Department of Agricultural and Business Development. So lots of big things to prep for a mock board, but we're excited. We've got lots to show them. So I have to prep for my next class. I have one more class for today. It's an elective, and I am going to be taking technology trends. Let me click on this real quick for you guys. We're watching technology trends of the future, and that's a 50-minute class. So I'm going to head to that, but yeah, you guys will be there with me. So I'll see you guys there. If I could sustain my body on instant coffee, I'd be alright. Just give it a spoonful of sugar, a little bit of creamer, and you know you're gonna be just fine. If I could sustain my body on instant coffee, that'd be real nice. So I could just save my money to buy a little honey out of bit of sweetness in my life. Just finished my class, and really all I have to say is wow. That class was taught by Linda Lee, and I have to say it was one of the most thought-provoking classes I think I've ever been in. We talked about like crazy things like 3D, like printing homes and Internet of Things and its application citywide, and it was way out of like what I've ever learned before. And really, all I can say is I'm interested to learn more. But no time to rest yet. We still have one more scheduled meeting, that is, and that's gonna be our mock board meeting. And I'm really excited for that because I think we have a lot of new things we can show our mock board. So I'm excited to see what advice they have for us today. Quick dog petting break as always, you know. Gotta make sure the dog is well petted. What's up, buddy? His name's Cole, by the way, in case anybody wants to know that.
Hey.
All right, back to LaunchX. If I can add to that really quick, yeah, I think that's like really interesting. We haven't looked too much into Snap benefits. I think, I don't know if it was the last mock board meeting, but we definitely heard about like the possibility of going into it, but we haven't done too much research on it yet, but I'd be definitely interested to. I would say the one similar thing we're doing is that we didn't mention it in our slides is we're donating to a local food bank. It's the Blue Ridge Valley Food Bank. And basically we're donating 10% of our profits. So for every box, that's about, I think, 8 meals that can be donated to that food bank. So we're using that as partial incentive for people to buy, but that's not like directly contributing to, we said like SNAP benefits. So I think that's definitely something we could look into. Just got done with my mentor meeting, and I must say it was pretty insightful. We met with Jay Heal, I think AD, Ricky, and Mishi. And they had a lot of advice on how we can go forward with our company. And I'm really excited for the future. Like after hearing from them, they had some really big ideas with like SNAP benefits and how we can contribute to charity to incentivize sales. And yeah, really I'm just excited for the future of our company. I'm taking this time really quick to take a break from all the LaunchX stuff because it's been pretty much nonstop since we started 8 a.m. this morning. So taking a little bit of a break, I'm gonna go throw the ball with my dog. And yeah, hopefully have some fun before I meet with my team again. Really quick, I also want to try and give you guys a quick rundown of what my company at LaunchX actually is. So me and my team are trying to make fresh produce as accessible as possible to middle to upper income families. Basically, we're delivering fresh produce, so fruits and vegetables, straight from the farm to our customers' doorsteps. And we're hoping to get 24 hours between when the food is harvested and brought to our customers' doorstep. On top of that, we're like focusing on an education aspect, meaning we're focusing on transparency and what are the actual benefits of each item of food you're purchasing. So that could be like you buy 5 tomatoes, you get a little card saying, this is what 5 tomatoes can do for your health, and so on. So really doing all that and trying to personalize the customer experience is how we're trying to differentiate ourselves. We're approaching the park now, so I'm gonna play with my dog for a little bit, play the ball and have some fun. And then we'll be back to our team meeting. So see you guys soon. we're back in the team meeting now. I will say it was incredibly hot outside, but we made it back. And right now what we're working on is we're trying to draft an email template that we can send to our local HOA so they can promote our business. And right now we're working on gathering the promotional materials and a description of how they can promote our company to people in the local area. So I'm gonna get on that, but see you guys later. It's been a minute since my last update. I've been on my team meeting for about 2 to 3 hours. We've just been doing work for our company, mainly working on our website right now, which I will show you guys in a sec because I'm pretty proud of our progress. But yeah, we're just kind of chilling. I had some course surveys to do that I needed to finish up, but yeah, now I'm back to working on the website. Right now we're mainly working on finalizing the main page, making sure all our products are good. We want to vary the content here so we can have different baskets people can buy daily for slightly different prices. We want to add more to our blog. And what we just finished was our About Us section right here. So we have pictures of our whole team. And then we finished this, but we haven't added photos. So we're going to need to add more photos to our More About Us. So yeah, I think we made some good progress today. Hoping to make some more before tomorrow, but I'll let you know when I update you guys.
It is now just past 9 o'clock, and I would say my day is coming to a close. I did some more work on the website with my team. We ended the team meeting. I was emailing back and forth with the general manager at our local HOA and trying to get them to promote us. So I think my LaunchX work is pretty much done for the day. So yeah, I took a quick shower and really I'm just hoping to go to bed soon. But before that, I'd like to give some quick advice for anyone coming to LaunchX. I would say if you want to be successful here, and not that I would know the best because I can't quite say that I have been successful at LaunchX yet, although I would say me and my team are on the right track to becoming a successful startup at LaunchX. I think we've taken a lot of the right steps. I would say some of the most important things if you want to come here is you need to be resilient, you need to have good teamwork, and you need to get comfortable with being uncomfortable. And I think I work with every single one of those every single day, especially getting comfortable with being uncomfortable, because everything I do, working with the Department of Agriculture at my county level, talking to these people who are representatives for the Homeowners Association. These are things I beforehand considered to be like adulting things in the most real sense. I did not want to reach out to them. I don't want to say, hey, I'm a high schooler and look at what I'm doing. I've never been the time to put myself out there and just, I always basically thought I would, they'd point at me and be like, you're a high schooler, you can't do this. But one of the things I've realized as I've gone on with this program is that being young isn't a reason to not be successful. It is a reason you can be successful. It's being young doesn't hurt you. It makes people want to invest in you, and it means that people see a future in you. So I think as I've really started putting myself out there, like messaging to these people and saying this, I'm young, but this is what I'm doing. They've really opened up saying, wow, that's crazy. You're doing this while you're this young. And they've been open to working with me. So yeah, that's my little tidbit of advice. And to paraphrase Professor Berger, and I wouldn't quote me on this. I'm not the most quotable person, but entrepreneurship really is like crossing a mountain, not climbing one. And that's because when you climb a mountain, that's only half the journey. You get to the top and you're done. But entrepreneurship, a lot of it is going uphill and facing new obstacles, and you don't know what's next. When you're climbing a mountain, you don't know how you're gonna get to the top. The path isn't quite clear. But when you reach the top, when you're halfway done with the journey, you can see the journey ahead, and that's when everything becomes easier. So really, when you get to that top of the mountain, things will become easier. And me and my team right now, we're really working on getting to the top of that mountain and outlining our strategy for getting initial sales for our product. But the way I like to end my LaunchX days is I like to end the day by doing something I enjoy. And something I enjoy a lot, which is a little bit obvious with all the things behind me, this guitar and keyboard, is I like to play music. So to end off the day, I'm gonna play some music and have some fun before I end up going to bed. So I'll play a song, and then that will be the end of this vlog. Hope I'm a good vlogger. I've never vlogged before. But yeah, let's play a song.
Love of mine, someday you will die, but I'll be close behind. I'll follow you into the dark, no blinding light, or tunnels or gates of white. just our hands clasped so tight, waiting for the hint of a spark. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied, illuminate the nose on their vacancy signs. If there's no one beside you when your soul embarks, then I'll follow you into the dark.